Leonard is an alum from the same graduate program that I went to, the School of the Art Institute of Chicago. So we were both in the photography program there. So that's where I met Leonard. And our chair, Kevin Goodrich, is also friends with Leonard from Chicago. So we knew him personally, and we knew just what like a wonderful person he was. And in addition to that, he's an amazing artist. And his work deals with things that are deeply and intensely personal, but also sort of in the context of our current political climate and debates about immigration and gay marriage and citizenship. His work seemed incredibly timely. And so it's sort of a combination of those factors that made us want to bring him in, both as an artist here, a specialist, and also through the visiting artist program. And so then when we were talking about those possibilities, it occurred to me that there were opportunities to kind of have them connect somehow. And that in the past, visiting artists have done workshops with our students, learning a particular technique, and knowing what I knew about how Leonard creates exhibitions, I thought that that could be sort of folded into a workshop, with the stakes being a little higher because it's actually going to be a solo show for him.
So as a group, we've kind of been working on getting this this whole room wrapped in this pattern that Leonard gave to us. He's got this tongue pattern because it kind of symbolizes this sort of heartburn that he feels towards his work and his projects. And I think that was really interesting. It was kind of crazy to get this pattern full of tones and be like, what are we going to do with this? And it just wraps the whole room, including the objects. I think it's really cool.
He's pretty direct in what he wants, but there's still a lot of us kind of translating his vision, because obviously he's not done this installation in a space before, and so part of our job is to kind of imagine with him and through what he's describing to us and the pieces that he sent us, kind of translate that into a physical space. So that's been really exciting. I think that's my favorite part about it.
We're basically putting like wallpaper up. We're going to be adding LED lighting. We're going to be lighting his pieces. There's going to be some different photo pieces, a video installation.
It was really kind of their show until Leonard got here. I mean, under his direction and with a little oversight from me, but they were managing it themselves. So
we have put in plenty of hours. It's hard because we're all working artists as well, so we've kind of been putting all of our free time here. It's nice kind of once we're all here in groups, things move along a little bit faster, but it's been a nice kind of like artist cohort. We're working together has been really fun and really kind of a learning experience for a lot of us, because a lot of us are going to be working artists later in life, and this is sort of kind of preparing us for the stress and the amount of effort that goes into putting on a really amazing show like this. And I think it's really cool that Cornish has got an opportunity to do so, because you know, this isn't something that just kind of comes along.
I mean, I'm really excited. It's great to feel like a part of a bigger whole putting together this installation. And I really enjoy Leonard's work. I'm interested to see like people's receptions at the opening. This is my first time doing an official gallery install like this, so it's been super fun.
Yeah, so Leonard will often create installations that are both his work and then sort of a stage for some of his other work. So he'll sometimes use, you know, a wallpaper room and then hang his video work and photographs within that room.
Okay.
And the wallpapering, he creates the patterns. So this is like a custom pattern for this particular show.
I'm excited to see when people walk in the room and kind of get involved in this one sort of just image that is just on everything. And I feel like that kind of encapsulates the feeling that he feels sometimes with the work that he's making. And I think it's really important that the work that we show and we do kind of shows the labor that we put into it, because a lot of his work is about his labor as an artist, and I think it's really cool that we can take part in that and sort of experience that the same way that maybe he has in the past. It's really interesting. I like doing it so far.
There's a lot of colors and layers and
it's a lot going on, and he wants to communicate his culture and where he's coming from.
One of the benefits of having a small program is that we work really hands-on with students. In a lot of ways, the faculty mentorship that students get is similar to a graduate program, and so that allows us to do things like this when we have a team of 10 students instead of classes of 30 students. So we're able to create these kind of opportunities for students. And it gives them very real world hands-on skills. It's essentially kind of a form of professional practice so that the students who worked on this exhibition now have a relationship with Leonard. He's gotten to know them. They can refer to this work and their roles on their resumes. It's a sort of, compressed internship or mentorship opportunity. So it creates stakes that are a little bit different than when they're opening an exhibition on campus, which is equally valuable, but this becomes something very public and very real that they can do that is co-curricular, connected to Cornish, but yet still sort of outside the bounds of how they think about school.